Thank you for joining today's Coffee Break webinar. Today's topic is Neanderthal Mini-Brains, exploring the archaic variant of NOVA1 through cortical organoids. The genomes of Neanderthals and modern humans are very similar. By investigating the impact of our genetic differences, we can gain insights into what separated modern humans from our extinct relatives. In this webinar, Dr. Kleber Trujillo and his team introduced an archaic variant gene of NOVA1 into human pluripotent stem cell-derived brain organoids. Organoids with the archaic NOVA1, an RNA-binding protein, showed altered gene expression as well as morphological and functional changes. Dr. Kleber Trujillo is a researcher with over 15 years of experience in neurodevelopment and stem cell research. At the University of San Diego, he took advantage of iPSC-derived models to understand human syndromes and to better improve personalized medicine strategies. At Stabonics, his work investigates human brain development with cortical organoids that brings lab research closer to patients in need.
Thank you for the introduction. Current views of human evolution indicate that many hominin lineages appear, but only one survived to the present. Neanderthals and Denisovans, two of these extinct lineages, are our closest evolutionary relatives, providing the most subtle genetic and phenotypic contrast to our species. Comparison of these genomes has shown that many humans today carry specific genetic differences that may have been important for recent human evolution. Knowing how these species genes differ from humans is important to help us understand what makes humans unique, especially in our brains. To determine the extent of these differences for brain development, we compared the human genome sequences with Neanderthals and Denisovans. We found a set of 61 positions in which all humans carry an autosomal fixed-derived mutation. The neuro-oncological ventral antigen 1, or NOVA1, includes one of these few protein-coded differences between modern humans and archaic genomes. NOVA1 regulates alternative splicing in the developing nervous system. Using CRISPR-Cas9 genome editing technology in human-induced pluripotent stem cells, or iPSCs, we replace the modern human allele of NOVA1 gene with the archaic variant containing a single nucleotide position substitution at position 200 that causes an isoleucine to valine change. To investigate the functional importance of this amino acid change in humans, we follow iPSC neurodevelopment through functional cortical organoids. Organoids have emerged as a scaled-down and three-dimensional model of the human brain, mimicking several developmental features at the cellular, molecular, and functional levels. A couple of years ago, we developed human cortical organoids that dynamically change cell population during maturation and exhibit a consistent increase in electrical activity over time. The spontaneous network formation of oscillatory events were dependent on glutamatergic and GABAergic signaling. Our approach provides opportunities to investigate and manipulate the role of network activity in the developing human cortex. Using the same approach, we generate cortical organoids with stem cells expressing the ancestral variant of NOVA1 found in Neanderthals and Denisovans, containing a single isoleucine to valine variation. It is called here NOVA1 human and NOVA1 archaic. We also generate other genotypes such as NOVA1 knockout archaic and NOVA1 knockout. Then, we follow iPSC neurodevelopment through functional cortical organoids for a couple of months. During organoid development, we measure its size and morphology. Although no differences were observed during neuroinduction, NOVA1 archaic and NOVA1 knockout archaic cortical organoids were smaller in diameter than the NOVA1 human organoids during the proliferative and maturation stages. To explore other potential morphological differences, we stretch two-dimensional outlines to generate 3D surface models of the cortical organoids. These models reveal increased surface complexity in NOVA1 archaic and NOVA1 knockout archaic organoids at the proliferative stage. NOVA1 archaic cells proliferate more slowly than NOVA1 human cells, owing to the reduced number of proliferative cells, developing then an aberrant cell layer structure morphology. Together, our findings suggest the reduction of organoid size and its increased surface complexity may be linked to alterations in proliferation and cell death. Next, we collect and sequence RNA from cortical organoids to capture potential alterations in gene expression and alternative splicing. Although NOVA1 is not expected to affect expression directly, splicing changes can have downstream effects of gene expression. We identify 277 differently expressed genes between NOVA1 archaic and NOVA1 human organoids at different stages of maturation, many of which are involved in neurodevelopmental processes. To characterize the cellular diversity of NOVA1 archaic cortical organoids during development, we perform single nucleus RNA sequencing. We use unsupervised clustering on the combined dataset of 50,000 nuclei to identify cluster and their relative abundances. Differences in cell type proportion were observed among the genotypes, leading to potential differences in regional identity. Gene splicing also varies between NOVA1 knockout, NOVA1 archaic, and NOVA1 human organoids. Alternative splicing events occur at significantly different rates between NOVA1 archaic and NOVA1 human organoids. The most common difference alternative splices were cassette inclusion and the alternative first and last exons. Many of the differently spliced genes in NOVA1 archaic organoids are involved in synaptogenesis and neuronal connectivity, as shown by a gene ontology analysis. For example, Homer 3, a member of Homer family of scaffold proteins present in the postsynaptic density, was spliced differently by NOVA1 archaic. Previous work has shown that the different isoforms of Homer 3 have different functions, suggesting that this alternative splice form may have functional consequences. To determine the binding preferences of the human and archaic forms of NOVA1 across the transcriptome, we perform eClip assays. We identify more than 30,000 significantly enriched binding sites for both forms of NOVA1, of which around 80% occur in intronic regions in human protein coding genes. About two-thirds of PIX regions are overlapping between the genotypes, and the binding sites of both forms of NOVA1 are strongly enriched for the canonical sequences motif. Notably, cells carrying NOVA1 archaic genotype preferentially select an alternate last exon and a shorter 3' UTR sequence of NOVA1 transcript, which corresponds to reduced binding density of NOVA1 archaic on the long 3' UTR. Since many genes differently express or splice in NOVA1 archaic organoids are involved in synaptogenesis and neuronal connectivity, we verify whether synaptic protein levels show an altered profile. NOVA1 archaic cortical organoids express lower levels of pre- and postsynaptic proteins, resulting in reduced colocalized synaptic puncta. To investigate whether the observed protein alterations affect synaptic protein interactions network, we use quantitative multiplex co-immunoprecipitation to characterize the abundance of these synaptic proteins. We identify 15 high-confidence protein co-associations that were significantly different, including Schenk, Homer, MGlu5, which binds each other to form the receptor scaffolding system, and PSD95 and NMDA receptors in SYNGAP, which contribute to activity-dependent plasticity. This data demonstrates a widespread change in synaptic protein network downstream of NOVA1 mutation. To evaluate the impact of synaptic molecular changes of neural network activity, we plated cortical organoids on the Axion Maestro multi-electrode array and measured the electrophysiological differences between NOVA1 archaic and NOVA1 human. As you might know, the MEA technology allowed dynamic extracellular recordings for a macroscopic view of neural networks. When evaluating the network activity, mature NOVA1 archaic cortical organoids display an increased number of bursts and a higher coefficient of variation, while showing lower synchrony levels compared to NOVA1 human. It was also observed that neurons from NOVA1 archaic cortical organoids display higher variability according to their firing rate. Our data suggests that expression of archaic NOVA1 variant leads to modified synaptic proteins interaction affecting glutamatergic signaling and neural connectivity. There are some limitations to our approach. First, our experiments use a specific human genetic background. It is likely that the genetic background between the archaic hominins and the modern humans differed such that much of the genetic variations in these human cell lines did not coexist with the archaic version of NOVA1. For NOVA1 targets, the NOVA1 archaic splicing phenotype in human genetic background may have generated a total new phenotype. The splicing differences observed in NOVA1 archaic cortical organoids compared with those observed in NOVA1 human can be interpreted as the first step towards a full understanding of the role of the human-specific version of NOVA1. Take these points into consideration, our results support the hypothesis that the archaic NOVA1 archaic genetic variant alters cortical organoid development in a modern human background. We think that these genetic changes was an important event in the evolution of the modern human species neural phenotype. With that, I would like to thank all the other authors and all the other agencies that help our work. Thank you so much.
And that is the conclusion for today's Coffee Break webinar. If you have any questions you would like to ask regarding the research presented, or if you are interested in presenting your own research with microelectrode array technology or impedance-based assays, please forward them to coffeebreak@axionbio.com. For questions submitted for Dr. Kleber Trujillo, he will be in touch with you shortly. Thank you for joining in on today's Coffee Break webinar, and we look forward to seeing you again.